So, as some of you might know, I was at NAMM this past weekend, and probably the most exciting thing to ever happen to me at NAMM happened. Robert Keeley gave me a pedal. It was awesome. I'm still super excited about it. He gave me one of these, the Compressor Plus. I was actually interested in these, and I dropped by to check out the Memphis Sun, but also to look at this one. He didn't have any Memphis Suns for me to try out, so I'm probably just going to give him a call and buy one. Like next week or so, but I was checking this out. He was showing me what made it special, and I was telling him about a particularly problematic guitar that I have that has some stupid hot pickups, that black 335 copy that you might have seen in some videos. Those pickups are they're stupid hot, especially for that type of guitar. I've got them dropped as low as they could go before they just fall into the body, and it still hits this guy right in the teeth. This guy never lets up when I'm using that guitar. It almost renders this thing useless. Like, I pretty much have to turn it off. I can't use it. Because just everything sounds really squashed. And if I turn down the volume, it gets muddy. So what makes this special is this little switch in the middle, which goes from a single coil to a humbucker mode. So what that does is it just ducks the input gain a little bit when you flip it over to humbucker mode so that you're not hitting it so hard. I don't know if it ducks the input down or if it just raises the threshold a little bit. But either way, it makes it so that when you're using humbuckers, the compressor can behave similarly to how it behaves with a single coil pickup. So I told Robert that I was just talking to him for a while, testing out the pedal, and then just out of nowhere he turns to me and he just goes, "Take this to your gig tonight, try it out, let me know how it goes." So it went great. I was able to switch between my Tele and the 335 copy, and I was able to keep this thing on the whole night. So that was awesome. But I was explaining what it does to some other people. They didn't quite get it, so I thought I'd give a little demo of that. I'm gonna be using this guitar because it's the only guitar I have with humbuckers and a single coil. This is not the problem guitar, but it's the best one to use to demo it. So I've got some fresh batteries in both of these. We're gonna go ahead and hook them up, and I'm just gonna play some stuff for you, and we're gonna compare the tune knob and how it responds to humbuckers to the Compressor Plus and how it responds to humbuckers versus single coils in the humbucker and single coil modes. So now you'll notice that the tune knob and the old four knob, those were identical pedals. The difference is that the two knob, those other two controls that you have on the four knob, those are relegated to trim pots inside. I was thinking that this one, the Compressor Plus, is the same way, but it's not. I opened it up, there's no trim pots inside. So we just lost the attack and knee controls. But I never had to change them on my two knob anyway. So I don't see, that's not a problem. Like, the default settings are great. So right now, let's see, here is, I'm just on a Roland Cube 20. There we go, there's my bridge pickup, and there's that middle single coil, okay? So let's just hit that middle single coil. I got everything at noon. Let's just hit that the two knob compressor with the single coil. Sounds pretty good. But now, let's go ahead and hit it with the humbucker, okay? You notice it's really squashed, okay? I'm not gonna worry about rolling the volume back or anything like that, because it's just hitting that really, really hard, and it's not letting up. We're kind of losing the sound of the guitar, whereas here, gets nice and spanky. We limit the peaks, we pull out the attack a little bit, get some nice clean sustain. But with the humbucker, it's just hitting it too hard. It's starting to sound muddy. Let's switch over to the Compressor Plus in single coil mode. I'm going to turn the two new knobs that we have on the Compressor Plus are blend, that's the white knob, and tone control, that's the extra black knob. So I'm just going to, the blend is a wet dry mix, which is a really cool idea for a compressor. So I'm just going to turn it all the way up so that it's behaving more like the two knob compressor. So here is the Compressor Plus with the single coil, alright? Now, first off, I notice it's quite a bit. It's not as noisy. It's not as loud. Let's switch back. Let's turn the volume down on that a little bit. Switch over to the two knob and I hit it with the humbucker. That's ugly. That's just too much. It's just too squashed. That's no good. So let's go over to the compressor plus, and I'm not going to change anything. I'm just going to flip this switch in the middle. It's now in humbucker mode. Let's hear how this compares to the two knob now. Compared to the two knob, I mean, that's a huge difference. Actually nice and spanky without sounding crushed. Yeah? Two knob, compressor plus. A lot more of the character of the guitar is actually retained in there. So let's just kind of explore that humbucker mode. Let's actually use this blend. I'm gonna move this blend back to noon. So now it's a 50-50 mix of the uncompressed tone and the compressed tone, which is really, really cool. So, and if I move it back up, you could hear the difference here. Move it back up. So it's kind of just cutting a little bit. I like that blend knob right in the middle there. It gets you that spankiness. That you associate with a compressor that you want a compressor for. But it doesn't crush the whole sound. So once again, let's just compare this one more time. I mean, this is so awesome. As soon as I saw this online, it's like, I have to get one of those. And as soon as I played it, I thought, yes, I need one of these. So once again, here it is in humbucker mode, okay? Because that's what matters. Humbucker, compressor plus in humbucker mode. Let's turn the blend all the way up so it's a better comparison. And switch. Compressor kick in. You hear that? But here, such a nice balance. So yeah, Keeley Compressor Plus. If you are like me and you've got, like, you like that compressor sound, but you're primarily a humbucker player, this is the way to go. Like, this thing is great. If you've got a guitar, or if you're switching guitars between humbuckers and single coils, and you want to keep your compressor going, then this is the way to go. But even if you just have a lot of humbuckers, which tend to hit compressors too hard anyway, then this little switch right there makes all the difference in the world.